Good evening to all of you. In our last lecture, we have seen the introduction to C programming language. We have seen different concepts of basics of C programming language. All the grammars like variables, constants, keywords, data types. Then we have seen input-output statements in C programming language. And at last, we have seen in the previous session, that is some programs on C programming language using input-output statements. So today, our topic is control structures in programming, C programming language. So, what are different control structures available in C? There are two types of control structures available in C, that is called as decision control structures and loop control structures. In decision control statements, we have statement like if statement, if else, nested if, conditional expression and switch case. And in loop control statements, we have for loop, while loop, do while loop, right? So we'll see all these one by one. So what do you mean by decision control structures in C programming language? Decision may be true or it may be false. Depending upon the true or false nature, we'll try going to execute the code from the program. If the condition result is true, we'll going to execute the true part of the code, else we are going to execute the false part of the code. So there are different statements that comes under decision control statement. We will see it one by one. Next is loop control structure. What do you mean by a loop? Loop is nothing but doing the same thing again and again. It is called a loop. So we have three different types of loops available in C programming language, that is for loop, while loop and do while loop. Now, we will see the decision control statements. In that, the first statement is simple if statement. The simple if statement executes the statements in the if block if the condition is true. Syntax for simple if statement is like this: if in bracket condition, and if the condition is true, we are going to execute these statements available into if block. But there is no action written in this syntax for false condition. So, we will see one example and we will check the result of the code. Consider this example: integer a equal to 5 and b equal to 7. Here we are checking the condition that whether a is greater than b. If this is true, we will going to print a, but otherwise there is no code written for else part or false part, right? So, what would be the output of this code? The output for this code would be blank, because here a value is 5 and b value is 7, and the condition of the if is result of the condition becomes false, and there is no code written for false condition here in the else part. So simple if statement like this will going to result a blank on the screen. Okay, there is no result on the screen. So note that there is no action for false case in case of simple if statement. There will be output on the screen only when the condition is true. So to avoid the drawback of the if statement, we have simple if statement, we have if else statement in C programming language. Now what is simple if else statement in C program? It executes the statements in the if block if the condition is true, otherwise it executes the statements from the else block if the condition becomes false. The syntax for simple if else is like this. Here, after if, we write the condition in the bracket. If the condition is true, we'll execute all the statements in the if block. Else, we'll go to the else part and we'll execute other statements written in else block. The else block will be executed only when the condition becomes false. The if block statements are executed only when the condition becomes true. Now consider the code given here and we'll try to find the output of this code. Integer a value is 5 and b value is 7. Here we are just checking if a is greater than b. If this is true, we'll print the value of a, otherwise we'll print the value of variable b. So here we'll get the correct output on the screen, because in this case a is 5 and b is 7, and we are checking here a condition that is a is greater than b. So the condition is false. So in this code, it will print the value of B. It goes to the else part and it print the value of variable B. So here it avoids the drawback of simple if statement. Now we'll see a simple program using if else statement. The first program on simple if else is to check whether a given number is even or odd. Now we know that a number which is divisible by 2, completely divisible by 2, is called even number. Otherwise, that number is odd. Now, how do you check whether that number is completely divisible by 2 in C program? We know that there is an operator called as modulus, which gives us the remainder after division. If the modulus operation gives me the result as 0, it means that number is completely divisible by 2. Okay. So, we will see into the program now. These are the header files we write in the C program, that is stdio.h and conio.h, void main. Then we declare one variable here because we need one number from the user. Then we use clear screen function to clear the screen. After that, we will prompt a message to the user, enter the value of n, and with the help of scanf statement, we will read the value of that number into variable n here. After getting the number from the user, we will put a condition in the f, that is if n mod 2 double equals to 0, double equals to symbol is nothing but the equality sign in C programming language, which checks whether both the sides are equal or not. If both the sides are same, the result will be true, otherwise the result will be false. So here we are checking the condition whether the number mod 2 is equals to 0, it means remainder after division is 0, it means that number is completely divisible by 2. If this condition is true, we will print a message that the given number is even. Otherwise, in the else part, we are going to print the message that the given number is odd. And we write getch and closing bracket to close the program. So, that was the small code to check whether the given number is even or odd. So the main part in this program to be focused is the condition written into the if statement, that is n mod 2 equals to 0. If this condition is true, we can say that the given number is even, otherwise the given number is odd. We'll see one more program using if else statement to check whether a given number is divisible by 3 and 5. It means I want to check whether that given number is divisible by 3 as well as 5 or not. So what we will do into the program, we'll take one variable n like this. Here we declare all the header files, then main program will declare one variable. In that, we are going to read the value from the user. Here with the help of printf statement, we'll prompt a message to the user. Using scanf statement, we will read that variable value n and see how the condition has been written here in the if statement. In if, we are checking two different conditions here. If n mod 3 equals to 0, and logical AND is written here to combine both the conditions, results of both the conditions. N mod 5 equals to 0. If the result of both the conditions are true, then and then only we can say that the given number is divisible by 3 as well as 5. Else, we can say that the given number is not divisible by 3 or 5. The next concept is nested if statements. When one if statement is completely embedded in another if statement, then this type of concept is called as nested if statements. So, the nesting in C programming language if statement can go up to n level. For example, some of the syntaxes are given here. Consider C1, C2 and so on are the conditions written in if statement. So, the first syntax for nested if is if condition 1. If the condition 1 is true, it will going to execute the statements from if block. In the else block, we are checking another condition we have another if statement in the else block. There we are checking condition number 2. If the condition 2 is true, it will execute these statements. Statement belonging to if block 2 here. Okay. Else, it will execute the statements belonging to else of second if statement. Okay. So, this else belongs to the condition 2, whereas this else belongs to condition 1, first if statement. Okay. So, we will see another syntax for nested if. Here, we are checking condition within condition. If condition C1, again we are checking in the if block, another condition C2. If C2 is true, if both the conditions are true, we are going to execute the statements from if block number 2. Else, we are executing this statement for if block 2. This close the first if block and this else belongs to the outer if statement. This else belongs to inner if statement. This will going to execute the statements only when the C1 condition is false. There is another syntax, that is syntax number 3 for nested if. If condition C1, in that we have another condition, there we are checking condition number 2. If the both the conditions are true, we are going to execute the statements from this if statement 2. Else, we are executing the statements for if condition number 2. In the else block of first if statement, we have another condition to check, that is if C3 is the condition, if this condition is 3, C3 is true, we'll execute this statement, else we execute the another statement for if block 3. There are many n number of syntaxes for nested if, because the nesting can go up to n level. We can have condition within condition within conditions also in the if as well as else block. Now we'll see the first example with using the concept of nested if. Now this is the first program to check the largest of three numbers. Write a program to find the largest of three numbers using nested if. So in this program we'll declare all the header files required, then void main. In that we declare three variables because we need three numbers. So with the help of printf statement we'll prompt the message to the user. With the help of scanf statement we'll read all the three numbers here. Then check how the conditions are written here. In the first if block, we are checking whether A is greater than B. If this is true, we'll check again if A is also greater than 3, C. If A is greater than both, that is B and C, we'll print the message that largest number is A. Else, we'll going to print the message that the largest number is C. Because this else block belongs to the condition A greater than C. So, the else part for this condition would be printf largest number is C, and we'll close the first condition here, and in the else block of the first condition we'll only check if B is greater than C. If this is true, we'll print the value of B, otherwise we'll print the value of C, because this else block belongs to the condition B greater than C. In the first if block itself, in the condition number C1, if we come to know that A is smaller than B, it directly goes to the else part here, right? And only checks whether B is greater than C or not. If this is true, it prints B, otherwise it prints C. So, we need to check whether this code works for all the three types of possibilities of inputs. Sometimes A may be greater, sometimes B may be greater, sometimes C may be greater. Try to give some random inputs to this program and check whether you get the proper output or not. Now, our first input is A is 5, B is 7 and C is 9, suppose. And I want to check whether which is the largest number. Here we are checking whether A is greater than B. Here itself we came to know that in the first condition only that the condition becomes false. So, it goes to the else part and here it checks whether B is greater than C or not. And B value is 7 and C value is 9 and the condition becomes false. So, it goes to else part and print the message that the largest number is C, that is 9. Like this, you can pass any inputs and check your output. If you have any doubt, you can ask me now.